Hello, welcome to the Dit & Works YouTube channel. A few weekends ago, I travelled up north to the Northwest Hi-Fi show to have a look at all the new wonderful products out there. It was great to be able to spend some time up there with people that I've never met in person but exchanged loads of emails and messages, and to catch up with people I hadn't seen in person for more than 20 years in some instances. One particular encounter stood out for me, that a chap kind of smiled and ushered me into one of the rooms. I had a listen to the equipment, and when I was coming out, I got that distinct impression that either I recognised him and I'd forgotten who it was, or they recognised me. And as it turns out, it was the latter. And the gentleman's name was Stephen Oakes, and he works for Neat Acoustics. And he'd recognised me from this channel. So I was over the moon that somebody in a, you know, big speaker establishment had recognised me and found my videos. And we exchanged, we had a chat, it was great, and I kind of left thinking I'd missed an opportunity there. Why on earth didn't I say, could I review some of your speakers? So having a chat with Sadie on the way home, I thought, I'm going to contact this guy. I really should, because if you don't ask, you never know. So I pinged off an email, and sure enough, Stephen replied and said they'd happily send me out a pair of Neat speakers for me to review. And there they are, the Neat Majistra, and we're going to have a chat about them now. So Neat Acoustics was founded by Bob Surgener in about 1989, and the interesting thing about him is he's a self-taught musician. So I'm wondering if the musician's ear, somebody who's really not only interested in playing music and listening to music, if their ear has brought something different to the table. So we're going to have a quick chat about some of the quite interesting technologies in these loudspeakers, and then we're really going to dive into how they sound, because that's really all that matters. Let's have a look at them. Okay, so most obvious, that's a true ribbon tweeter. Some of my friends are absolute fanatics when it comes to ribbon tweeters, and I've got to admit, I really enjoy a ribbon tweeter as well. But there have been instances in the past where I've heard ribbon tweeters that just don't integrate very well with the other drive units, because they're so fast, they're so coherent, they are so good that it's difficult to get them to marry up in a two-way system. But I've got to admit, Neat have managed to do this. So this drive unit really does blend very well with this true ribbon tweeter. So it's obviously a very clever design crossover. But things don't end there. Sticking with the front, this material here is a different material from the rest of the cabinet. So you've still got all your dimensions of front baffle, sides, tops and back, but this is an additional material stuck to the front. I will stick that animation up from Neat's website that will show it in better detail. But I think the reason they've done that is you've got particular resonances with all materials. So they've built the cabinet in an almost traditional way, and then stuck this additional baffle on the front with its nice sort of beveled edges there. So you've got different materials that's helping absorb different resonant frequencies, making the cabinet very inert. Then, rear ported, really nice terminal block there, which presumably is where the crossover is bolted to. Lovely binding posts. But what you can't see is divided down here is sort of a brace, if you like, with another driver inside, and that's called an iso-baric design. And I'll show a little sort of technical drawing, if you like, of that there. And as you can see, that the drive unit firing with the external drive unit and very clever port tuning means that all of the frequencies, not only from the front but from the back of the driver, are able to interact with the cabinet and then ultimately us as the listener in a different way, which does make these sound very, very good in the low frequencies. More about sound in a minute. Fit and finish. I've got to say that this veneer is book matched, that this is virtually identical to the other cabinet. And I really like that. Book matched veneer is something that sort of oozes quality. It means some thought and consideration went into the cabinets. And these do look really nice. I presume that's an oak finish. So something else, I do love this when you get a new speaker, I love this, that you get books and stuff to read. So the first thing you do, you can read the setup. And in red, running in period of approximately 200 hours. Now that's not unusual for a loudspeaker. I've had several new loudspeakers over the years that really didn't sound brilliant out of the box, and they took some time to run in. One particular offender, actually two particular offenders, I won't name them now, took absolutely ages to run in. And one of my friends has also got a pair of those, and he suffered the same thing. Took an age to run in. So approximately 200 hours, you'll whittle through that. That won't take long at all. The Majistra should be stood on 45 to 60 centimetre tall stands. I've got my target 60 centimetre lead filled stands that I put them on. And placement in the room. Now this is worth its weight in gold. The Majistra is intended for close to wall placement. Now that's really beneficial to a lot of people who have either confined living spaces or furniture in the room or a strange shape of living room that won't permit you to bring the speakers way out into the room. And before I continue with this, I did try them really quite tight up against the wall. And although I preferred them at my usual distance, which was actually slightly further into the room than 30 centimetres, which Neat recommend, but they did sound absolutely fine, pushed quite tight into the corners and quite far back into the room. So that's handy. That's really beneficial for some of us, particularly rear ports. I have had speakers in the past that I could not use effectively in this room because I had to keep bringing them further and further and further into the room to the point that it almost got a bit ridiculous. So yeah, can run them close to the wall, but I preferred running them a little bit further out. But setup guide, warranty, 5 years, good stuff. The other thing, nice little catalogue, which always makes for good reading while you're listening to your music and enjoying the speakers you've just purchased. So if we move over to the Majistra section, so they fall into the Strata range. So there's lots in that range. There's an Orchestra, which is a tall, slender floor stander. The Majistra, which is the ones I've got here, which are a pretty good size stand mount speaker in my honest opinion. You don't want really enormous stand mount speakers, and really tiny ones, although I'm a fan of those, can get a little bit lost in some rooms. But the MINISTRA is probably the one that a lot of people will have heard of, because I believe it was on the popularity of the MINISTRA that this was then developed. Right, so we've got setup guide. We've talked somewhat about the technologies in here. Let's have a listen or a chat about how they sound.
Ever made by man, I'm going into this mic written by this hand, I'm coming out of this mouth made by this tongue. I tell you now, my man, my name is Young, but so you think that this is destiny to get the best of me, but I suggest to be quiet, but don't even try for me, the rest of me, taking it and never breaking it, don't even shaking it, grooving it and always moving it, cause I'm not faking it, pulling out rhymes like books off the shelf, born in ignorance and hollow, stuff I go for myself, this is stone cold rhyming, no frills, no bluffs, and it's no accident that these rhymes sound tough, I'm going off, baby, there's no turning back. Thank you.
has broken down inside. Everything has changed. Dawn of a new day. Don't know where it goes, but this is what I know. We rise together.
Apart from Christian McBride, I used recordings that weren't the absolute best I had, and I did that on purpose, not to make these speakers sound worse, but to give you a real world situation of how good they can sound, even with a recording that's not particularly brilliant. So for example, Know How by Young MC is a very bright recording, and it's also a track compiled of loads of different samples apart from his voice. So his voice is live over a track compiled from samples. And I think you'll detect from that sound clip that his voice was incredibly good. Hidden Citizens is a very compressed track, although it's got incredible bass impact and her voice came through clear and crisp as anything. I didn't actually show it in the clip, but I had goosebumps when that track really kicked off. And that's always a marker for me that something good is happening. So just to describe how these speakers sound, and those sound clips were at pretty elevated levels, I wouldn't be able to sit there and listen to it at that volume. It was very loud. But it was to try and give you some of the impact of the speakers. At normal listening levels, sitting in my preferred position, the imaging is stunning. They're absolutely stunning. And that's got to be down to the way that that ribbon tweeter works, the way their dispersion works, their timing, their coherency. Imaging, stunning. Bass, phenomenal. For a speaker of that size, you'd be shocked. If you closed your eyes, if I brought somebody in here blindfolded, played them, they would think they were listening to an enormous set of floor standers because the bass impact is incredible. Now, there have been some reports of people saying these are particularly bright. Well, I think there's one of two things that's happening there. Poor system matching, or they're not following this guide to the letter. Now, I appreciate I've pushed them just a little bit further out into the room than what these recommend, but they worked equally well pushing them further back. So they definitely will work in a room that you're restrained by how far out into the room you can put the speakers. So Christian McBride was phenomenal. The speed and the bass playing, everything was fantastic in that. Hidden Citizens, although it's a heavily compressed track, it still came through really, really well, very listenable. And the last track is from a film I saw years ago called Fear, which is probably the first film I saw Mark Wahlberg, Marky Mark, in. And I always enjoyed the music. I thought the music was really, really good. So I chucked that clip in there just to show how heavy the drums can be if you need them to be. So in a nutshell, these speakers look fantastic. Appearances second to none. The acoustic properties of these speakers are brilliant, absolutely brilliant, and you can play them to fairly ridiculous levels, and there's no harshness, there's no brightness, there's nothing that's really fatiguing, apart from I just couldn't get away with listening to music that loud. I think next door would kick off, and probably next door to them would kick off, because that was very loud. And that was just a test I did to see what it was like at elevated levels, because you really want to push a loudspeaker to get it absolutely sounding its worst almost. And these held it together perfectly. Absolutely brilliant. So, ribbons, perfect. Bass, perfect. Size, room positioning, all very easy to accommodate. The only downside I could find to these loudspeakers, and I'm quite familiar with this, let's just check we get the specification right. Does it say on here 86 dB? Now 86 dB is not horrendously low. I've had speakers that are 84 and even 82 dB, but 86 dB does really mean you're going to need a fairly powerful amplifier to get the most out of them, or at least an amp that can deliver current when it needs it to. So I'm not sure what wattage I would recommend, but certainly my amplifier at 200 watts per channel was giving them everything they needed. So if you had a more powerful amplifier than that, even better. I would say that system matching might be something very, very, very important. That some of the reviews that are saying these are particularly bright, I think that is system matching. That I bet if I put this with some of the brighter amplifiers I've had, or more detailed amplifiers I've had, you'd probably find at lower volumes that would be very nice, but as soon as you turn the volume up, it would probably get a bit too much. As where my system's fairly neutral, it's not particularly bright, it's not particularly warm, suited these speakers very well. I absolutely love listening to them. So I've got to say a massive thanks to Stephen Oakes for sending these to me. An absolute joy to listen to these speakers. I wish I could keep them. I really do. They're that interesting to listen to. And they're very modern in their sound, so you can play more modern music and absolutely thoroughly enjoy them. But even if you divert to better recordings from classical artists and jazz artists, they just get even better, which is what you want. So if on the sound clips you think, I purposefully used not the worst, but also not the best recordings, that was streaming, so that was actually sent via Apple lossless files to my Blue Sound node. So again, not the ideal. I could have used vinyl, I could have used CD, I could have used Cobras with super high res files, but I didn't. I wanted it to be a real world test, and they passed with flying colours. Absolutely brilliant job, Nee. Take care, I'll catch up with you soon.